Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. This is Markita from At Home with Kita. I'm so glad that you're here today because I'm going to be sharing my first project from the Container Store Ambassador Team, which I have been selected for. So I'm really excited to show you a simple way that you can organize under the sink, which is a problem area for a lot of us. It is for our family. So I'm really excited to dive right on in, share with you guys all of the things that were sent to me for this project, and then we're actually going to complete the project from start to finish. So if you're new to my channel, I hope you'll stick around and consider subscribing. I also hope that you'll give me a thumbs up if you enjoy this video. So I'm really super excited to have been chosen as one of 20 brand ambassadors for the Container Store. You guys know I love all things organization. And so when I saw the application process come out, if you guys saw my Instagram, you already know how I felt about it. I said, I'm gonna put myself out there. Not sure if it's gonna actually work out, but let's do it anyways. And so when I was selected, I was beyond words. And I am in great company. There's so many fabulous ladies who were chosen and gentlemen, and I am really excited to work with them to see and absorb all of that inspiration from all of the upcoming projects. I think you guys will be excited, and I just can't wait to get to know everyone and connect with everyone and just really share our love of all things organization. So the first thing I thought I would do is share with you guys the welcome box that came in. If you are on Instagram, you've already seen this, but I'm gonna open it up and just share with you all of the initial things that were sent to us. And then I'm gonna show you all of the things that arrived for this project specifically, which is under the kitchen sink. We were able to choose either a drawer or under the cabinet sink. And I felt like that was more of my problem area than drawers, although sometimes those can tend to get messy as well. And so I'm sure sometime in the future, I'll be organizing some drawers as well. So stay tuned, because I did also tell you guys that I'm sharing more organization on my channel. So this is right on time. So I'm going to unbox everything and show you what I picked up. All right, y'all. So this is the welcome box. This is how everything came in this really cute, like, tote box. It has a fabric sort of texture. It's really pretty. It has like a little pattern there, so I'm hoping you guys can see that. So I am going to open this up and share with you guys everything that came inside. All right, hello. You guys can't see my face, but I thought you would definitely want to see this more so than me, okay? So when you open it up, it has all of these nice things that we can use to get started. So first and foremost, it came with the home edit book. So this is an organizing workbook. So this is going to come in handy throughout this whole entire process. It also came with a label maker. Now, who doesn't need a label maker? So I'll be using this in some upcoming organization projects. So label maker is up next. Then we got this bin clip label. So I'm really excited to implement that. We've got a measuring tape, which we're definitely gonna need, right? And then it also came with a notepad for us to take some notes, jot down some ideas of what we wanna do in terms of our next project. And then not lastly, a couple more things before we get to the last thing. And then it came with this putty. So I'm excited to see how I can use this. Also, some ballpoint pens. Who doesn't need a good pen, right? And then lastly, we got a gift card for us to use whenever we need additional items outside of what is sent to us for the projects. So this is my initial gift card, and then there's another one that comes midway through. So that is everything that we received, in addition to this nice box that I feel like I can use to store some things in as well. So I wanted to first show you that, so everyone got the same box, and it's just a little thank you welcome box to get us going. And it also came with a manual on what we are to do throughout this whole process, some tips and tricks on how to take photos, how to post. It was really cool. So that was very useful, and this is all gonna come in really handy throughout this process. So now let's talk about what I received for this project specifically. So the process in which they have everything structured is pretty genius. They are very organized in how they run this whole program for our ambassadors. And so this process was very easy. It was streamlined. And so I was able to go in and select what I wanted based on my space. And so again, we're doing under the cabinet sink today. So I'm going to share with you all of the things that I got for that project. So let me, I'm gonna pull the box over and frame so you can see this is one of the boxes. And then there's also a very large box down here that I'm not gonna be able to hold up in front of the camera, obviously. So let me go ahead and open up this initial box and so you guys can see what I picked up. All right, so I got this Elfa storage drawer. It is medium and white, and so it gives you a little photo of kind of how it's supposed to look. So this is part one, and then this is the other part of it. So this all goes together, so I'm gonna show you that in terms of how you put it all together as well. So this is first up. So I love a good Lazy Susan. So I got two of these smaller Lazy Susans. These are really cool because you can stack them, as you can see. And from this side, you can see how you can take the containers out and remove things and kind of shuffle things around. So I thought this would be really cool to add to the space. So I got two. And so I am excited to implement these. So of course you're gonna see the whole entire process of that, but these are really, really cool. As you can see, it just makes it easy to be able to store those little knickknacks and such. And so these are gonna work great for this system. And I love how you can stack them. So again, with the Lazy Susan vibes, we got a large Lazy Susan. So as you can see, this thing is massive. And I got two of these as well. So it's got the little rolling thing on the bottom here, of course, hence the name Lazy Susan. And that's kind of how it looks in terms of the size and how you can kind of position things in there. So I got two of these. Now these don't seem to be stackable, but we're gonna incorporate them into the space to really get things organized. So I know this is gonna work great. And lastly, I got some clear organization bins. I love clear bins, we all do, for just organizing those things. So I got them in multiple sizes because I just didn't know what I would need. And so we got two of them in the smaller size here. I love the little lip in the front for you to be able to easily grab these out. You can insert them inside of other things. So I may put these inside of the drawer unit that I got. You're gonna see that whole entire process. I also got three of these size. So these are gonna work out great as well. And then I got two of a larger size. They do have handles on the side, so that way you can easily pick them up as they get heavy. You're going to need those handles there, and all of them have handles. And then I got three of the larger size. That's even larger than this size. It's just larger by just a little bit, so not so much. So again, handles on the side. I love how they're clear with a little frost hem, and so I'm looking forward to getting all of this added to the space. We have a pretty decent size under the sink, so I'm sure most of this will fit, but I'm not sure if all of it will. So we're gonna do another project using whatever's left over for another under the cabinet sort of situation, probably in the kitchen. So stay tuned for that. We're not gonna do that in this video, but we are gonna do that sometime in the future. So I'm done sharing with you guys everything that I received. So let's head on over to the space. So this is the space that I'll be working with today. As you can see, the dimensions of it are just a little awkward. The shape is a little awkward. We've got some space here in the corner. We've got some space over there in the corner. So it's a little bit more of a trickier space to work with. The pipes are a little bit low as well. So we are gonna do what we can do, you guys. And I think we'll be able to get this done and it to be able to look really chic and organized. So I'm really excited for the process. So I went ahead and pulled everything out of the under the sink area. So this is everything that was under there, including these items up here. All of this stuff was underneath that sink, you guys. And so this was really a problem area for us, as you can see, because everything was just kind of strewn about and there was no organized way about it. It was just jumbled up inside of the cabinet there. So my husband, he's so lovely, he actually built a little platform thing for me. This right here is something that he just added for me because I just wanted to add a little bit more stability down here. And so he went ahead and just made that little wooden part there for me so I can be able to add all of this stuff underneath the sink. Nothing will sink, nothing, you know, it'll just add a little bit more stability, which is what I needed. So there's not much of before in terms of all of the stuff underneath the cabinet, but this is the before of what we are actually working with now and what we're gonna organize into the space. That's all of the stuff right there that we're gonna be using once again. So let's go ahead and get this show on the road. All right, y'all, these are super awesome. I love these so much. So these are the Lazy Susans I was showing you earlier. I love how these little compartments come out on either side. You can take all of the compartments out if you want. You can also remove this little piece in the middle if you don't need any of the compartments. You can use these separately in another project. Take this off right here and you have just a regular Lazy Susan. This is like the coolest thing ever. So I am not gonna use them like that. I am actually going to stack them, and that way I have a little height. I also can be able to store more things, which is what we want here, especially when you're dealing with a space like mine. So we've got one, and then this is the second one. And again, I talked to you guys about how they are stackable, so that's really cool. They still turn while they're stacked. So these are gonna work out perfectly. So I'm gonna go ahead and add these to the space. And what I typically do when it comes to all of my organization projects, you guys, is I do a mock setup. So I lay everything out just so I can see positioning. I can make sure that this is going to be the right location for that particular item. I want to just kind of set it all up, preliminary, of course. And then once I get it all set up, I know that that's where I want to put it. It's going to function the way I need it to function. Then I'll go ahead and remove everything out and I'll stock it with all of the items that go in that particular compartment or container. All right, y'all, so now we have the layout configured. So I can go ahead and remove everything since I know where it's gonna go, and just go ahead and start stocking it with the items that are going back under the sink. Also, you guys, a quick note about this in terms of assembly, this does get bolted down to the cabinet over there. So I'm gonna do that later. I'm gonna have my husband do that. But it's pretty cool how you do it. It's very easy, but I am not that handy. So I'm gonna have my husband do that when he gets home. It came with all of the nails, these two pieces, and of course that shelving piece right here. So for now, I'm just gonna get it all stocked up and then I'm just gonna slide it in there. And then when he gets home, he'll do all of the assembly for me. Alright guys, so I've got everything in the space under the sink, and as you can see, the transformation is amazing. So I have so much sense of peace now that everything is organized, everything in its place. I purged wherever I needed to purge because a lot of that stuff I didn't need. Some stuff was outdated, so you also want to take a look at those things that you don't necessarily need anymore or that are expired or outdated. You want to purge as well. Simplify. And so that's what I was able to accomplish as well. So everything looks clean. I've got all the necessities there, and it makes me want to go in there as opposed to shutting it off and pretending like the problem doesn't exist. The problem did exist. And so I was able to come up with a resolution thanks to the Container Store, who of course sent me all of these fabulous products for me to use in this project. So thanks to them, shout out to them. The Container Store is amazing. We have one here in our local area. We also have a few others spread out throughout the state, so make sure to check out your local Container Store. You can also shop online. They have everything that you need to organize your space. So I am looking forward to this whole organization series where I'm gonna take you throughout the house and we're gonna organize lots of things. Every month we have a project that we do have to complete via the Container Store. So I am excited to go through this journey with you guys and share with you guys some ways that I have been able to use their products, to organize the house and get things in order. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. I really enjoyed the process. Let me know if you have questions on any of the items that I used throughout this whole process. I will link everything below that I use, but if you have questions outside of that, feel free to let me know. So thank you guys again so much for watching today. I appreciate you stopping by my channel to catch an organization video, which is my heart. I love all things organization. So this didn't really feel like work. It just felt like a fun process. And I hope you guys really enjoyed it as much as I did. So I hope that you guys will consider subscribing to my channel. If you're new here, hopefully you'll give me a thumbs up in this video if you enjoy it, and you'll come back and you'll catch another video. In which case, I'll see you guys then.